Hello, everybody. My name is Jim Gamble, and today I want to tell you a story. This is the story about a boy from Norway whose name is Peer Gynt.
You see, Peer is the Norwegian word for Peter, and this story was written over 100 years ago by a famous Norwegian author named Mr. Henrik Ibsen. Now, Mr. Ibsen's story became so popular that he asked his musical composer friend, Edvard Grieg, to write some special music so that his story could be presented as a play. But I know you want to get on with the story, so let's meet our hero. His name is Peer Gynt.
Out there, you lazy boy. Playing again? You should be doing your chores, cleaning your room. Do you hear me? You should have a job. Are you listening to me? All you want to do is play, waste your time. Oh, he could have a job. He could earn his keep. Do you see that good-for-nothing son of mine? Oh, what will I do with him? Peer, you never listen to your poor old mother. I wash your clothes. I fix your food. I work my fingers to the bone. Speak up, Peer. Peer, what did I just tell you?
But, Mother, I tried...
Play, 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 you're lazy, Peer.
I want to see the world before I settle down. I want to have an adventure.
See the world? See the world? All you will find are those who will trap and trick you. Those who will do you harm.
Mother, I must find out for myself.
Then go. Find out for yourself. But beware. Things are not always what they seem.
Goodbye, Mother. Goodbye, friends. I will return. Someday.
And so, with only the clothes on his back and dreaming large, exciting dreams of adventure, Peer left his little village.
I thought there were more people in Norway. Oh, boy! I made it! Oh!
Finally, Peer came to the deepest, darkest mountain forest he had ever seen. In the clearing in this dark green forest, a strange woman was doing an even stranger dance.
Some strong young man to work for me. someone to take care of me and my children. I need someone to be my slave.
And what are you?
I am a princess.
A princess? Then where is your kingdom?
I live with my father, the Mountain King, deep in the forest. It's a place full of adventure, just right for a strong young man like you.
Full of adventure? Sounds great.
And if you pass the test, you can become one of us. Just take that path, the one over there, straight to the Hall of the Mountain King.
All right. I'm off to seek my adventure.
And now I must hurry and take the shorter path to get there first.
Finally, Peer came to a great stone hall. It was dark and ancient, and so large that it appeared to be cut from the very heart of the mountain.
Hello? Hello? Anyone there? Are you the Mountain King?
Yes. What do you want?
I want adventure. I want to become one of you.
One of us? To become one of us, you must pass certain tests. Can you pass the test?
I can do anything.
First, you must never again go out into the light of day. Will you agree?
Well, okay.
Second, you must grow a tail like us.
I'll try.
And third, you must marry my daughter, Green Hilda.
I'll have to think about that.
Then sit there on that magic carpet and meet those who will become your brothers.
Thank you.
You're Green Hilda, and your children are all trolls. I'm getting out of here, right now. Magic carpet, take me away.
You think you have escaped, Peer Gynt, but I will follow you wherever you go.
Wow, this is great. I wonder how you steer this thing.
Finally, the carpet's magic was exhausted, and he began to descend to a strange, exotic land called Persia.
Whoa! Whoa! Ouch! Ooh! Ow! Ooh! Let me off. I've come such a long way, and far away from that Green Hilda. But I'm tired. And sleepy. I need a rest. Maybe a nap. Over here. Where am I? What an unusual dream I had. Whirling dervish. Dancers. What an adventure! Thank you. Oh, no, not you. I must run.
And run he did. Peer ran all the way from Persia to the Serengeti Plain in Africa.
This is the strangest place yet. Now this is adventure. Whoa, I think I'd better hide over there and see what's going on.
Even as Peer Gynt was watching the strange dance of the masked pygmies, Greenhilda was already in Africa. She had taken on the disguise of a magical shaman witch doctor, and she was searching for Peer from one side of the Serengeti to the other.
Down, kitty. Nice, kitty. I've had enough adventure. I'm heading for home. I'm going to take the first ship for Norway. My chances on my own. Norway, I'm coming home, even if I have to swim all the way. Mother! Mother! Hey, everybody! I'm home! Mother, I'm home!
Peer? Peer Gynt, is that you?
Yes, Mother, it is me. And I'm so glad to be home. I saw the world. I found adventure. But Mother, my adventures were almost the end of me. First, there was the Mountain King, who was really Green Hilda. And the Whirling Dervish, and the pygmies with the scary mask. And then the ship sank, and I swam from Green Hilda's back.
Peer, what an imagination. Come in, my son. You need a rest.
And so Peer returned to his home in Norway and spent many hours telling his friends and neighbors about his adventures in Persia and in Africa and in the Hall of the Mountain King, and also of narrowly escaping from Green Hilda. And the more he told the story, the more he realized that Green Hilda was more than just a witch. She represented all the evils and temptations that boys and girls face in the larger world. And so, I would like to remind you of just one thing. Don't let any Green Hildas catch up with you.